Hello, dear ones. It's Alice. I am of the stars. And I have a picture for you, a mental picture, regarding the noosphere and the Claire chatter that more and more people are hearing these days. If you could imagine that the Claire chatter is like water. And we're talking now in terms of fluid dynamics, which I know nothing about, but I do have this metaphor to offer. So imagine that the noosphere, the body of like mental knowledge in the planet that's trapped in this planetary realm, and the Claire chatter that we all hear are water, right? And far off in the mountains, there's this torrential rain, right? And that rain is some noospheric event on Earth. Say there's a natural disaster. Okay, so that's like the torrential rain in the far off mountains. It's not near you, say. And the water comes gushing down through the mountain passes and down into the rivers that go down into the cities, that go down into the sea, right? And you, with your own clear chatter, individual noosphere, are hanging out in an almost dry riverbed. And so, just having a good time of it, wading around in the water once in a while. There's high, like, banks on either side, so it's hard to get out. And all of a sudden, there you are, just enjoying your noosphere. All of a sudden, this torrential rain, this flash flood comes straight down the river and sweeps you up, right? This is like a storm of negative emotions that sometimes happens in the noosphere. We all have, when we're embodied in physical form, we have some negative and some positive emotions, or we couldn't stay in physical form, because physical form is a realm of great, great duality. It's a great duality experiment. And the emotions that we have, they're in the fourth dimension compared to the third dimension, which is the physical realm. So the fourth dimension has that allows us to embody has both negative and positive emotions in it. So then we can distill down into physical form, which has even greater disparity of poles, of negative and positive poles. All right, so there we are hanging out, and we have certain negative emotions. These are cause our emotional body to be swept downstream as the great storm of negative Claire chatter hits us. Okay, so downstream we go until we reach the ocean, and pretty soon we're just bobbing along in the ocean. We're not really sure what happened in a great sea of negativity, along with a lot of other people. All right, so what can we, and this happens over and over again, right? It seems to be. So what can stop us? What can help us stay in the place where we are without being swept along in other people's negative thought forms? The thing that I found that works is God. Okay. When I was young, I made a spiritual practice of chanting God's name, either out loud or in my mind, for a certain length of time every day. And I think that this is a very helpful practice, very helpful. It helps lift the mind up and refine the astral matter on the astral plane so that we can stay centered even when other people are not. That's both third dimensional and fourth dimensional, I think. So this is a very good practice to undertake to align ourselves with God. Then later, most recently after 2012, and this may not apply to you, I found that by chanting God's name and churning the ethers in the fourth dimension, what would happen is that the negative clair chatter would become stronger. And my feeling about this is that, gosh, there's a lot of traffic on this tiny street. I can't figure it out. Maybe they're all going to church. So anyway, my feeling is that since the 2012 shift, all of Earth, all of the noosphere, every other energy on Earth is rising to meet the incoming light's level. But there's a balancing process taking place. So if one person ratchets up their noosphere into a very refined astral state, then there has and maintains that, as many spiritual students do and have done in the past, and it's been very important to do so in the past because the world was so full of dense energies, right? But now, during this shift, I find that by churning the ethers with God's name on the astral plane, I'm causing other people of more dense astral matter to act out or to become more negative and to increase their own negative clair chatter. So what I finally experimented with was embodying Christ consciousness in my body instead of using clair words or speaking God's name out loud, simply, silently, and with a neutral mind to embody that state of refined energy insofar as I'm able to. And this alignment with the will of God, either through speaking, if that works for you, or through feeling, if that in the body, if that works for you, however you can manage to align with the will of God, maybe by reading scriptures, you know, your sacred scriptures. That's like we're standing in the riverbed, right? Fooling around, like having fun, living our lives, and we suddenly see the flash flood coming, and we grab a twig from a tree that's right there, and that twig saves us from the flash flood. And that twig's name is aligning with God. The tree is God, and the twig is that way that we align with God in that moment. Well, this is all fine and dandy, you know. We say, at the very last moment, when the flash flood comes, then I'll align with God, right? But the trouble with that is, unless we live our lives in that way, it's very difficult, extremely difficult to come up with that on the spur of the moment when the adrenal glands are working overtime, you know? So, yeah, I suggest for at least a few minutes a day, do a meditation that allows you to align with the will of God. My very favorite is the Great Invocation, channeled by Dwal Cole. I love that one, but there are many, many others. So that's my metaphor. Y'all have a wonderful day. Take care.